So now let's take a look at how you can use your foam roller to roll out your quadriceps and your IT band. So on the mat. So I'm going to put the front of my thighs on the roller. I say go into kind of an army crawl position. The roller is on my thighs right now, and I can roll all the way to my kneecaps, not over them, and then come on back. Up and down. And then I also like to do, I call it like a quarter turn, where I get kind of a diagonal leg. To me, this is the most effective tissue toward one. And then you can also go directly on to the IT band as well. So depending on how good or bad this feels, I usually recommend people do about 1 to 2 minutes on each part of the leg. And do on both legs. This is something that you can do as much as you would like. We're never looking for sharp pain or anything like that, anything super, super tender that feels wrong, like it hurts. Don't push through that. But otherwise, stretch often to try and move some things up. So now we're going to look at how we can use the foam roller for the upper back. And to stretch out your shoulders and your neck and work on your posture. And stretching out your neck is a little bit of a misnomer. I don't actually recommend rolling on the neck, but by working on stretching out your chest, your pecs, to work on posture, you can make your neck feel better. So there's a couple different things we can do. We're gonna do thoracic extension. So I usually say knees bent, feet flat on the floor. Hold up your hair if you have long hair, otherwise you'll end up rolling on it. So the simplest thing to do is just to extend backwards. But if you're looking for something a little bit more aggressive, you can lift your body and roll on your upper back only. Leave the neck and the low back alone. That's for upper back stiffness. You can also lie on your roller vertically. It is long enough for pretty much everybody to be able to lie with both their head and their butt supported on the roller. Typically, I'll start with just seeing how it feels to have hands clasped on the belly. And then if that feels pretty good, then I'll have people start with palms towards the ceiling, relaxing, letting everything go, and then you kind of walk your hands up until you like the amount of stretch that you get. Some people top out at this 90 degree angle. If they are tight, that is fine. Everyone should stop at 120. More than that, you're making the shoulder looser and not necessarily a good way. So usually I tell people no more than 120, but 90 is pretty common. And a shoulder that is really sore, say you do have rotator cuff irritation, a lot of times it's gonna look like this, like you can't quite lower that arm to the floor, so that's where you start down in those lower reaches, or if it's really uncomfortable, you just start here. Typical recommendations for how often to do that, feels pretty good, so, and it's a mobility exercise, so doing this multiple times per day to try and maximize your benefit is a good idea. Some people are amazed how good this feels. I still don't recommend trying to sleep on it or spend hours or anything like that on there, but multiple times a day for sure can be beneficial.